Should you insulate your attic with fiberglass, cellulose, or spray foam? Let's talk about it. Welcome to Foam University. Today we're going to be discussing your best options for insulating your attic. We're going to be talking about fiberglass, cellulose, and spray foam. Before we get into that, please go below, hit that like button for us. Thank you. First, fiberglass. So first, let's take a look at fiberglass. Now, fiberglass, in my opinion, is a good enough option. What you would typically see with a fiberglass install is fiberglass would be on the floor of the attic, and you would have venting put in the soffit going up to the ridge of the attic, possibly gable vents also, but that's what you would have, a traditional attic insulation setup. Insulation on the floor as well as venting throughout. Now again, fiberglass, like I said, is good enough. You would typically see a single layer fiberglass put in, and then over the years you will usually see a homeowner add layers to that fiberglass for several reasons. One, over time that fiberglass can start to break down and actually diminish over time, so you want to add to that to get it back up as far as efficiency and effectiveness. Now also, if any pests or rodents get inside that attic space, that fiberglass can get torn up really easily, and it can retain odors and weird stuff like that. So again, another reason you may want to replace or add to that fiberglass later. As well as potential moisture issues that could come in and be present in the attic space, that could also cause damage to that fiberglass, as well as just airflow causing that fiberglass to shift and break down a little bit. All reasons why you may want to add to or replace that fiberglass over the years. Second, cellulose. So next we're going to take a look at cellulose as an option for insulating your attic. Now again, this is usually going to be a traditional attic setup where you put fiberglass on the floor. You would also put cellulose on the floor of your attic and have venting put in place, again usually in the soffit and ridge or potentially gable vents. So with cellulose compared to fiberglass, cellulose would be a better option. It has better resistive capabilities as far as thermal resistance. It can tend to last a little bit longer. However, cellulose still has some of the downfalls, being that it will shift over time. So if you have loose blown cellulose in the floor of your attic, any airflow or drafts that come into your attic will push cellulose up against the walls, the soffits, any type of corner or structure that's in the attic. You will oftentimes look up in there and see cellulose that is banked up or drifted up against those ledges or edges. And now you have an unlevel or low place where that cellulose needs to be raked back, or you may have to add layers to that cellulose over the years because it has broken down, either through pest damage or moisture damage, things like that. Over the years, you will want to add layers to that cellulose to get it back up to that peak performance. So again, if you're looking at this, cellulose can be a better option for you. Third, spray foam. So now if you're looking at using spray foam to insulate your attic, this is where things can be a little untraditional. So you can always put spray foam on the floor of your attic and have your standard vents, either, you know, soffit, ridge, gable vents. You can use that system, absolutely. However, when it comes to spray foam, you will oftentimes see homeowners putting the spray foam right onto the roof deck itself, actually sealing off the soffit, sealing off the ridge, going to a completely unvented attic system. That's usually what we recommend anytime we do an attic, whether that's an existing house that's been there for 100 years or a new built house that was just put up this year. Usually an unvented system is the recommended way to go. Now obviously, some strong benefits with spray foam. It's an air seal. It establishes that building envelope on the outermost layer of the building, which is crucial. We always talk about establishing that. Next, it is the best performing insulation when it comes to thermal resistance, actually stopping that heat transfer, that hot air from getting out in the winter, that hot air on the outside from baking into the attic in the summertime. Spray foam does that job very, very well. Now, obviously, the con to spray foam is that it will be the most expensive product out there. That comes anytime you're looking at spray foam, it's usually going to be the most expensive. But like we said, it performs the best. And unlike the other things that we've mentioned, you will never have to add layers to re-rake or anything like that with spray foam, because it is a one and done solution. You put it in place and it is warranted to stay there for the lifetime of the building. So keep those things in mind when you're considering spray foam. Now let's compare all these products. So now let's look at all three products. So really, if you're looking at fiberglass, cellulose, and spray foam, we look at this as a good, better, best type of situation. Fiberglass, it is the least expensive. It can be a DIY option if you want to do it yourself, but it will require some things. So keep that in mind. And it also is the least effective. Bumping up a little bit to cellulose, again, you see a little bump up in cost. You still require some of that maintenance. Can also be a DIY project, but again, not quite peak performance. So keep those things in mind. Now, if you're looking at spray foam, again, now you're looking at the top end of performance, zero maintenance, but it does come with the highest ticket cost. So if you can afford the cost of spray foam, that will be the clear, obvious answer to you. So keep all these things in mind when you're considering what's best for you and your attic. If you want to learn more about the best option to insulate your attic, please check out the link below. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and ring that bell to see all of our notifications.